In the past 2 weeks, the oldest Anarchy server in Minecraft has been in turmoil. Maybe turmoil is an understatement. Absolute chaos is probably a better way to describe it. To give you a quick rundown, 400 players have been banned from the server. Not by the admin, housemaster, but by other players using the book ban exploit. This action ended up with an admin response that set all of the following events into motion. Game-breaking exploits, base and stash deletions, outright bans, players attempting to take matters into real life through doxing. It has been absolute insanity. In this server's decade-long history, I have no doubts that what's happened in the past week will go down as a notable event. Today, I'll be giving you a timeline of the events from start to finish, show you the aftermath, and then I'll be giving you a chance to discuss who was in the right and who was in the wrong down in the comments section, and if the player base took things too far. In today's video, I'm going to attempt to stay as neutral as possible so that I can give you an unbiased view of the events. So, let's get started. To understand today's video, let me give you a 30-second explanation as to what a book ban is. In the Java edition of Minecraft, it's possible to use books to ban someone from a multiplayer server. First, a player crams as much text as they can into a single book. Then, they fill a shulker box with copies of that book. Then, they throw these shulkers to other players. If you pick up these shulkers, you start sending too much data to the server, so it automatically kicks you. Even if you log back in, you get kicked again, over and over. The only way to become unbanned is to have an admin wipe your inventory. That is what a book ban is. Now, originally, Housemaster patched this exploit so that it wasn't possible on the server anymore. But here's where our story begins. A few weeks ago, two players used a hacked Minecraft client in order to write the entire Christian Bible on 2b2t, with the whole thing taking up 13 shulkers worth of space. Now, originally, they wrote it just for fun, but near completion, they noticed that opening and closing the chest it was stored in caused massive server lag spikes, usually being severe enough to crash the entire server. When Housemaster realized what was happening, he had to temporarily disable the patch that originally fixed book banning in order to stop the lag from opening the chests. By doing this, the authors of the Bible accidentally book banned themselves, as their shulkers were in their inventory. Not too long after, two players, Steve3 and HouseHouseHouse1, found a different exploit involving death messages in chat that allowed them to kick everybody off the server at once. Now, recently, House's policy has been that if you lag the server to the point that it becomes unplayable, or you repeatedly use exploits to kick players or crash the server, he won't hard ban you, but he can remove your priority queue access even if you paid for it. House found out that these two had been responsible for the player kicks, so he removed their priority queue and even wiped their inventories and e-chests completely clean. House had dealt with the players that were causing trouble, but he forgot to re-enable the fix for book banning. With the realization that book banning was back, the players that had their priority queue removed, as well as a few others, created a group with the sole purpose of book banning as many players as possible. They appropriately called themselves the Book Club. For several days, the Book Club stood in the Nether at 00, book banning all new players they could find. They set up chambers that allowed them to instantly book ban anyone who came through. If a player had a few inventory spaces open and picked up the shulkers, they got the ban hammer. After only a few days, over 400 players had been banned. The majority of these banned players began emailing Housemaster, since he was the only one that could clear their inventories and get them unbanned. since Housemasters saw the damage these players had been causing to both the player base and the server itself, he compiled a list of the members of the book club Discord and priority banned all of them. Not only taking away their priority queue access, but preventing them from buying it again in the future. Now, here's where things get a little bit confusing. This is a list of the accounts that were priority banned from 2b2t. This list was given to me by the book club themselves. You'll notice some of the names have the word innocent next to them. This is because these players were part of the book club Discord, but were not directly responsible for lagging or banning. House threw the baby out with the bathwater. It seems that in order to make sure the majority of the book banners were stopped, he did a blanket ban on all of them. After this mass banning, several members of the book club Discord became enraged and went as far as to start attempting to dox Housemaster and the people that House works with. Realizing that this was a disproportionate response, the members of the book club responsible for the doxing were promptly banned by its leaders. But the damage had been done. After several emails back and forth regarding the members who were innocent, Housemaster restored their priority queue access, but those that were responsible were still banned. House patched book banning, but also ended up patching a very popular exploit called Peek. Peek allows you to view the contents of a shulker without actually placing it down and opening it. By House patching this exploit alongside book banning, a lot of 2b2t regulars became upset that they'd lost such a useful hack. But at the end of the day, it's House's server, and if something makes the server unstable, he can get rid of it. But back to the book club. With many of their members still priority banned, they hopped on alt accounts to begin the next phase of their operation. No Server November. The book club pledged that they will crash and lag the server every single day of November as revenge for collectively losing their priority queue. They built lag machines across different areas of the server, and as of this video, they have crashed it every single day of November, with House removing the lag machines they built and priority banning accounts responsible. The book club has actually gotten quite bold, even going as far as to build lag machines at 00 in the Nether, right in public view. Just a few evenings ago, this particular machine kept the TPS at almost zero for 3 hours straight, effectively making the server unplayable. With House attempting to stop the lag machines, the club have tried to stay one step ahead, coming up with new lag machine designs and testing out new exploits. They've basically attempted to take the server hostage. So right now, it's Housemaster versus the book club. Kinda reminds me of Batman versus the Joker in a way. Batman never kills anyone, just like House never hard bans anyone. He just takes away their priority queue. So now, what is the fallout of these events? How has the 2b2t community responded? Well, alongside the server getting crashed constantly and House battling the lag machine builders, the community is pretty divided on how they feel about the book club, with some claiming that House is doing what's necessary to keep the server alive, that he's the good guy, and that the book club should rightfully stay banned, while others actually support the book club, claiming House should be more transparent about what is actually allowed and what isn't in the anarchy environment. So now, here's what I want you to do. In my comment section right now, there's a certain kind of comment I want you to type, so that way I can automatically sort them into a poll. I'm doing it this way to make sure that only those that made it this far into the video know how to properly vote. You're gonna tell me, who do you support in this scenario? House or the book club? Start your comment with either House or book club, then tell me why you support them. I'm not gonna give you my opinion just because I'm trying to stay neutral in this whole ordeal, but once you've typed out your comment, post it. I'm curious to see what the FitFam thinks of this whole situation. Now, if you haven't already, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel to learn more about the oldest anarchy server in Minecraft. We are going to see how the rest of November plays out at this point. Will the book club continue their crashes every single day? I guess we'll see. But for now, take it easy And if you plan to play on 2b2t, try and stay alive out there.